talking to my friend. She's Puerto Rican. She was like, Rosie, white women have got to stop wearing hoop earrings. You guys are appropriating Latin culture. And I was like, all right, cool. I get it, you know? Like, your people came up with this shit. But if you want me to get my own identity, my people came up with appropriation. I'm like, technically, I'm very in touch with my background. It's like, I will see your hoop earrings and I'll take them. That's what we do. It's just hard to tell a white person to get their own identity. It's like telling a homeless person to get a job. It's like, where? Should I just look at this trail of shit I've left behind me, see if I can make some connections back there? So I went through a breakup. I'm fucking killing it. Batting 1,000. It's my year. Yeah, I'm good. And yeah, so let's see. My cat died, my dog died, my boyfriend left, and I started fucking a DJ, which is somehow worse than all three of those things. Truly, I am unhinged right now. Like, I'm about to make a lot of mistakes. Like, forget fucking a guy with a neck tattoo. I'm about to get one. It's fun, though. It's fun to be crazy. I'm being such a whore. It's fantastic. Truly, I'm so empty inside. If a man came inside me right now, he could hear an echo. It is wild. I've been through too much. Like, I've just gotten to that point in my life where it's like, yeah, I'm not gonna pretend to gag on your dick like I haven't been swallowing bigger disappointments since I was born. I'm 33, I've outlived Jesus. I'm not gonna eat your ass. Unless it tastes like a book deal, in which case, you know, we can talk, because that's on my vision board. You talk about that. This is like why I wanted to get married to my last boyfriend so bad. It's like, I just didn't want to meet a new person. I didn't want to date ever again, you know? Like, I was desperate to get married. Oh my God. I was just jerking him off like I was banging on a vending machine, just trying to shake a ring out. It was aggressive. I'm probably not married because I was jerking him off. Just be honest, I should have blown him more. That's what my grandma says. She's a huge whore, my grandma. I'm just kidding, she's dead. I have one sister who's a nurse. And, you know, I know I was giving the healthcare heroes shit earlier, but I do want to say this on her behalf. Nobody appreciates nurses as much as they do. They're heroes. They are. And they'll tell you. Now, it's not that what they're doing isn't heroic. It is. It is a heroic thing. But it's a bummer to hear about. And they never shut the fuck up. Don't ever ask a nurse how her day went. No, you're gonna get a story that's gonna fuck yours up, right? It will. I called my sister, hey, how's your day? It was pretty rough. Like, surprise. I took the bait, I was like, what happened? She goes, I had to pull the plug on my favorite patient. Your favorite patient. What do you do to the ones you don't like? She hated that. She was so mad. Not everything has to be a fucking joke, Rosie. I was like, no, you set it up. I feel like I knocked it out of the park. This was teamwork. We're both killing.